Now we're finally getting around to looking at the front end of the bike, and that means we got to have a look at the brakes. That's a pretty important part of the whole thing. I don't have really good high hopes for that master cylinder. It's really rusty. The appears to be frozen. There's no fluid in there. I think it all leaked out. So we'll start by taking it off the bike and have a look at it, see if it can be salvaged or what we can do. So the first thing to do that is I'm going to loosen the brake line, just because it's a good time to do it when it's still attached to the frame. So hopefully it comes loose. Yeah, good. Don't need to take it off all the way, but just loose. We can just unplug these wires. Okay, I got to disconnect the cable next, and it seems like it's frozen, but maybe I can just tap it. Oh yeah, it's lightly frozen. I can disconnect the cable, take the little barrel out, and then essentially the master cylinder is held in place with a hose clamp. It's not the original hose clamp, but it seemed to, like it did the job. And then this is the brake light switch on these old models. Now we can just pull the cable through like that. And now it's essentially loose. Now because we loosened that before, pretty easy to unscrew it. Now this one doesn't have any fluid in it. If yours does, you want to like suck the fluid out with a brake vacuum bleeder or something like that. So there's a little plunger in here that goes between the actuation arm and the piston. So make sure you pull that out so you don't lose it. And then unscrew the master cylinder. Dry as a bone. Oh boy, this is gonna be fun. So I'm gonna have a look at this thing, try to get it apart, see if there's any way I can salvage it. Okay, so let's take this thing apart and see how bad it is. I'll put it that way. Start by taking the reservoir off. There's a couple of different versions here. This is the real old version that has a little clip there, and it's held in place with a screw. You need a 7mm socket to remove that screw. Later models have essentially here in this position an Allen 8mm Allen that you put in to remove. But anyway, what you see might look a little bit different than this. These are the parts that are inside here. Whoops, there we go. This little piece fits in the hole there, essentially. And clip sits like that. So in case you have the newer style, now you know what the older style looked like too. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and just take this brake light switch off of there. Okay, now this piston has to come out. And the way that is done, there's a little spring clip in here, a little circlip. You need some circlip pliers that have very, very small holes in them. In fact, so small that I don't even have one of those. But luckily you can get in here with a little screwdriver and just pry that clip out. So I'm just gonna take the socket off and push this piston down. And just get in there. Yeah, this is pretty much what I was afraid of. You can actually see all kinds of crud on there. And there's a spring comes out here. So there's a lot of rust in here. And once I hone that out, it's probably going to be pitted. And I would say there's a good chance I'm gonna have to replace this part, but I do have a friend who's really talented machinist, and I'm gonna see if he can't put a stainless steel sleeve in there for me. And we've done that in the past successfully, and then they really last forever. So that's about all I can do with this right at the moment. And it's nothing I can do here. So I'm gonna move on to the next thing, which is the oil pan. I drained the oil out of this, and not too happy with the way the oil looks. Pretty grimy looking, pretty dark. So I don't wanna take any chances. I'm gonna go ahead and take the oil pan off just so I can get all the oil out of it and clean it, clean the oil pan, put a new gasket on there. So get started on that. To do this work, I got the center stand out of the way. You'll see it's the bike's just sitting on the wheels. If you have a lift, that's cool. If you don't, you're gonna have to come up with some way to support the motorcycle off the center stand, maybe across a board, a long board with a couple of straps or something like that to support the motorcycle. But the center stand sort of gets in the way. So just simply remove all the bolts, not much to this. Okay, all the bolts are out. Give it a little tap, see if that gets it loose. Oh, that's all it took. Yeah. I'd say that was a good call. Now, this is not the original oil pan. This is some kind of aftermarket. I actually don't even really know who made these oil pans. But maybe somebody out there knows, and I'd love to know. But it's pretty cool because it has this cutout here, so actually you can still use the center stand unmodified. We're gonna go ahead and just clean that up. And while we're in here, we're gonna replace the gasket. Okay, what I'm trying to do is just get a piece of it so that I can start underneath and hopefully just kind of cruise around, like it's kind of coming off nicely. You just gotta sort of pick a spot to sort of break through the gasket. And then if you're lucky, you can just sort of peel it off and push your scraper in all at the same time. Sort of try to get off as most intact as you can. It's working out pretty well. For this, it's really nice to have a pretty wide, thin, sharp scraper. Okay, that's most of it. Okay, I just got to scrape off the rest of the remnants. This is a very tedious task. It's good sometimes just to put some soothing music on so you can relax. Let's see what we can find. Perfect. Gasket's pretty well scraped off, so I'm gonna take this opportunity to change the oil filter. When you remove the oil filter, you always want to make sure that these rubber seals are still attached, and especially make sure that they're not still stuck on the shaft. You probably won't really ever run into this anymore, but way back in many, many years ago in the beginning, these seals were not actually attached. They were just separate O-rings. And if one were to make the mistake of putting in an extra O-ring, you would crush the filter and cause an oil pressure loss. So it's always a good idea on a bike that you don't know, just getting to know, that you look inside and physically make sure, visually make sure that there's no O-ring on that tube here, on that shaft. And if there is, you need to get that thing out of there. So we're gonna go ahead and put a new oil filter in here. This is a Mahle filter. And there's a few different versions of oil filters for these two valve twins. This one is just the one piece variety, which is the right one for this application because you got a really easy shot in. There's also one that's hinged that can be used, and it's very cool if you have engine bars or something you need to kind of snake around. And then there's also, of course, the version for the oil cooler, but this is the least expensive, the most basic one, top quality Mahle filter. Let's just slide that right in. And then I'm going to go ahead and replace the gasket on this cover here too, while I'm at it. All right, just lay the new gasket on there. There's no real pressure here, so the sealant is not absolutely necessary. The gasket will stick on its own. Now I'm pretty confident we got all the oil out of this. So we put fresh oil in there. It's gonna be purely fresh oil in this whole motor, which is great. So it's time to put the pan back on. This is, here again, the one that we took off, kind of a cool old relic. Edwards had his eye on this thing since we found this bike. And so he's got plans for this on his one of his projects. So we're gonna go ahead and put a original oil pan on there, the same that it had when the bike was new, which is fine. Having a deep sump oil pan is a great idea. It gives you an extra liter or more, depending on which version of oil, and that's more oil is better. A couple of ways you can do that. One is we actually offer a deep oil pan, looks like this. As you can see, quite a bit bigger. It holds 3.5 liters, as opposed to the original two on these, or the 2.5 on the deeper oil pan, but it's a nice amount of oil. And it's just the complete replacement. Best used on 81 and later models because they don't have this top part on the center stand. They just have one strut going across. This would interfere with that, so you'd have to modify. But it can be done, it's no big deal. You just basically cut that strut off, leave it off entirely, or just re-weld it a little bit lower. Can be done, it's no big deal. The other option, if you want to increase your oil capacity, is this part here from Siebenrock. This is really cool too, because it fits right in between. It basically goes in between the motor and the stock oil pan. Also vastly increases your oil capacity. And this part is available in silver like this. It really closely matches the rest of the motor. Also available in polished and black. So a couple different options for you. But what we're gonna do is put this oil pan back on, and I've just cleaned the bolts up a bit. The pan's nice and clean, and you could put some sealer on here, but it's just gonna make life harder if you ever need to get back off again. These are really high quality gaskets that we offer, special material that will actually do a really good job of sealing. So it's just a matter of putting the bolts all in evenly and torquing them down evenly, and then we'll be good to go. So let's get started. Got all the bolts in hand tight, and now I'm gonna go ahead and torque them to 10 newton meters. Okay, that's all torqued to spec. And don't forget to put the drain plug in also and use a new crush ring. All right, let's put some oil in this. And to do so, we've got this pretty cool little funnel from Siebenrock that is designed to fit beautifully right inside. It's made of like a silicone sort of thing. So it's a nice thing to carry with you on the road. Just makes it a little bit easier to get that oil in. And speaking of oil, this is what I like to use, 1550 from Liquimoly. It's a mineral-based oil, very high quality, and sort of the old standard, it seems, for years has been the 2050, but the cool thing about 1550 is it's just a little bit thinner when it's cold, so it makes it just that much easier to start, and once it gets up to temperature, you still have the 50 weight protection in the motor. So that's what I've found works really well. This is a 4-liter container, so it's enough for 2 oil changes on one of these, and almost enough for 2 if you have a deep sump or a later model. It's also graduated on the side, so you can kind of keep an eye on where you're at as you use the oil. So we need to use about half of it. Okay, let's start with that 2 liters. Next thing we're going to do is go ahead and spin the motor with the plugs out just to get oil pressure and get everything happening inside there. But that'll have to wait for another day because I want to do some checking on the electrical system before I get to that point. And it's enough for today anyway. So come back and see us on our next video. We're going to be tearing into the front end, getting into everything that has to do with that and the electrics and getting the bike back on the road here pretty soon. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already and leave some comments if you'd like down below. We like them and we'll answer you as soon as we can. So in the meantime, happy trails. See you later.